VAR can be used to create both query variables and expression variables. You use it in query variables along with define to create a variable that exists for the lifetime of the query. And you can use var inside an expression along with return in order to define variables which are only local to an expression. Let's see an example of the usage of variables inside a query first. Here I'm using define var to create a variable that exists only for this query. The variable is named colors and sales, and its content is a table that is the result of summarized columns by color and brand, where I create also an additional column amount, AMT, that contains the sales amount. The table contains three columns, color, brand, and AMT. Even though that variable contains the columns, if you need to reference the columns in the variable, you still need to use the lineage of the original columns. So I need to use product color or product brand if I want to reference to the, if I want to reference the color or the brand column in the variable. Indeed, you see that I can use the group by function to group colors and sales, but I need to use product color in order to access the column color in the colors and sales table. And then I can iterate over the current group and compute amount, AMT, which is the column created inside the variable. I do not need to provide a name because variables do not have a table name by themselves. But if I want to compute minimum, average, and max, I can iterate over current group. If you look at Contoso sales checks if the brand is Contoso. And to check if the product brand is Contoso, I need to use product brand. I cannot use colors and sales brand because colors and sales is a variable and it is not a table. You can create variables inside a query, as I did here, but you can also create variables inside an expression. In that case, you need to use var along with return. In the var part, you define the variables. You can define multiple variables in the same statement, and then the return part defines the result of the expression. So here I'm computing the sales in the last year in this first variable. I'm creating the sales in the current year in the second variable, and then I use in the return part sales last year and sales in current year multiple times. Variables have the great advantage that they guarantee you that the evaluation of the expression will happen only once. Even though in this expression I'm using sales last year multiple times and the same happens for sales current year, using variables is useful from an optimization point of view because it guarantees that execution of the code will happen only once and then the value will be reused multiple times. The usage of variables in the right way is very important for making the code more readable. Indeed, in this query, I'm computing an ABC analysis using variables. And you see that I create a first variable that contains the product with the sales amount, then a second variable that contains the running total of sales, which is a variable where inside I define another variable. The first is a query variable, the second is an expression variable that has the scope of only amount and running total. Then in product and sales running total percentage, I define another variable and I create a new column. And finally, in the products and ABC, I create the ABC variable, the ABC column that contains the ABC class. It's not important to look at the code and understand the details. It's only important to note that with a careful usage of variables, the code is at least readable. If you try to write the same expression without using variables, it will become a nightmare, a lot of code nearly impossible to understand. With variables, the rule is very simple. Whenever you are in doubt whether using a variable or not, use it. Your code will greatly benefit from that.